Select the tables which represent y as a function of x. For a quick review, recall the domain is the set of all inputs or x values, the range is the set of all outputs or y values, and a function is a relation in which each input or x value has exactly one output or corresponding y value. Looking at the first table, notice the domain would be the elements 4 and 8. The range would be the elements 2, 6, and 12. Focusing on the input or x value of 8, notice the x value of 8 has an output of 6 and an output of 12. Because the input of 8, or the x value of 8, has two outputs or two corresponding y values, each input does not have exactly one output, and therefore this first table does not represent a function. Let's also show the mapping of this relation. The domain of the relation would be the set with elements 4 and 8. The range of the relation would be the set with elements 2, 6, and 12. And now to map the relation, for the ordered pair 4, 2, we would draw an arrow from 4 in the domain to 2 in the range. For the ordered pair 8, 6, we draw an arrow from 8 in the domain to 6 in the range. And for the ordered pair 8, 12, we draw an arrow from 8 in the domain to 12 in the range. Notice we can easily see the x value or input of 8 has two corresponding outputs, not exactly one, which is why the first table is not a function. Looking at the second table, notice no x values are repeated. The domain would be the elements 4, 8, and 13, each of which have one corresponding y value or corresponding output, which indicates this table does represent y as a function of x. And let's also map the relation to show it's a function. To do this, we'd have to include the element of 13 in the domain. Notice the range is still the elements 2, 6, and 12. For the ordered pair 4, 2, we draw an arrow from 4 to 2. For the ordered pair 8, 6, we draw an arrow from 8 to 6. And for the ordered pair 13, 12, we draw an arrow from 13 to 12. We can easily see from the mapping, each input or x value has exactly one output or corresponding y value, which again is why the second table is a function, and therefore we check this box. Looking at this last table, when determining whether tables represent functions, we really only have to focus on the row or column that represents the x values or domain. If none of the x values or domain values are repeated, then the table would represent a function. So for example, here, notice the domain is 4, 8, and 13. None of these values are repeated in this row, and therefore each input or each x value does have exactly one output. 4 has the output of 2, 8 has the output of 6, 13 has the output of 6 as well. Again, each input has exactly one output, and therefore this table does represent a function. But let's also map this function to make it even more clear. To map the function, the domain is still 4, 8, and 12, but now the range is only the elements of 2 and 6, so we'll delete the element of 12 from the range. For the ordered pair 4, 2, we draw an arrow from 4 to 2. For the ordered pair 8, 6, we draw an arrow from 8 to 6. And for the ordered pair 13, 6, we draw an arrow from 13 to 6. Notice each input does have exactly one output, or each x value does have exactly one corresponding y value, which is why the table does represent a function. Notice it doesn't matter that the inputs or x values of 8 and 13 share the same output or corresponding y value. Each input has exactly one output, and therefore the table does represent a function. I hope you found this helpful.